Belinda Audiobooks presents this unabridged recording of The Gizmo Again, written by Paul Jennings and read by Francis Greenslade. Be sure to visit our website on www.belinda.com. Details of other available and forthcoming Belinda audiobook releases can be found at the end of this recording. The dedication reads, To Anthony. Chapter 1. Jeez, I'm looking forward to this. My cake is so good that I feel weak at the knees. It's covered in strawberries and cream, all yummy and mushy. I was going to eat a bit under the desk, but Mr. Billings saw me and gave me one of those looks that says, better not. So I had to wait until lunchtime. My stomach has been rumbling all day. I have never been so hungry in all my life. But now the big moment has arrived. I'm sitting on a bench in the playground, all alone. I lick my lips. I open my mouth. I close my eyes to take the first bite. Oh, I'm so hungry. This is going to be great. The smell is in my nostrils. My mouth is watering. There is nothing better than a scrumptious cake. Oh, yes, yes, yes. I open my mouth wider. Snatch! What? What's this? It's gone. My lovely cake is gone before I can eat a crumb. Someone has grabbed it. Someone has stolen my dream cake. Oh, no. No, no, no. Not again. It is Gutsit and his gang. Already they are making off across the yard with my cake. I'll never get it back now. In any second, it will be sliding down Gutsit's throat. They've done this before. Nearly every day they take the best bits of my lunch, and I just sit and put up with it. No one, but no one, ever stands up to Gutsit. He is the biggest kid in the school. Tough, mean and selfish. Nearby is the smallest kid, a new boy, Mickey O'Shea. He is also sitting all alone. Poor kid. He doesn't have any friends yet. You know what it's like in a new school.
Hey!
I yell at Gutsit.
You can't eat that! Give it back!
Gutsit looks down at me. Can't I? He says. Just watch me. And I do watch him. With a sad heart and an empty stomach. I look on as he takes an enormous bite. I watch as half of my lovely lunch disappears down his cake hole. Gutsit and his two mates have been making my life miserable all year. They take my lunch. They steal my pocket money. They twist my ears until they feel as if they're about to drop off. Every day when I wake up, I think about Gutsit's gang and worry about what they're going to do to me. It's the first thing I think about in the morning and the last thing I think about at night. But now, I have figured out a way to stop them. It's worth a try. I've been planning this for quite a while. It's the only way. Can I join the gang? I say. The three of them fall about laughing.
What? A little runt like you?
Says Ginger Girk.
What a joke!
Gutsit holds up his hand. No, boys, he says. We have to take this seriously. This young fellow wants to join. He could be tough, you never know. We have to give him a chance. I smile. This is good. If I join the gang, they will not pick on me. They will leave me alone.
Okay, says Gutsit. You can join the gang. But you will have to be initiated.
I'm not sure what this means, but I don't really care. Now that I'm a member of the gang, they will leave me alone and pick on someone else. Gutsit takes another bite of my cake. What's left of it?
Not bad, he says. Not bad at all. Anyone like a bit?
Mickey O'Shea, the new little kid, is sitting nearby. He does not know what has been going on. When he hears Gutsit say, Anyone like a bit?
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.